please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
CNBC TV 18 Weekender, only on CNBC TV 18.
Hi there, it's the Weekender on CNBC TV 18, and this weekend, if you're skewering around at home, look no further. Come to your nearest Barbeque Nation's restaurant and play around with their skewers. Well, I have with me a very special guest, the MD of the company, Mr. Kayum Dhanani. Thanks a lot, sir, for joining us this weekend.
Thank you for having me.
So you are IPO bound. How does it feel?
Well, a lot of anxiety. Yeah, a lot of travel, meeting lots of new people, learning lots of things.
Eating a lot more food, no?
Well, I wish I could. Unfortunately, well, that's not the case right now.
So just wanted to know from you, this business was started by your family members. You inherited it. Did you always wanted to be a part of this sector itself?
I have been involved with my brother, who's the founder of this business. While he was there, and on and off we used to talk about this business, how customer reactions to the offerings and multiple situations that the businesses went through, the markets, consumer behavior, and always this was one of my interests. However, directly I was not involved, but indirectly I always used to spend time with him, and he has been my mentor.
So how did the idea of Barbeque Nations come about? You guys were into the business of hospitality. You all had Sayaji Hotels, a lot of properties there. They were doing fairly well.
My brother was, he used to love consumer feedbacks, and he would always want to react to what consumers would ask. And such thing happened when he was running his hotel in Indore by the poolside. Many customers would say that, you know, what is new, what is different. So one of the winters, he got this idea of doing barbecue inside a restaurant. And that's where the idea came about. Consumers loved it. Yeah, so from there the idea came about.
So the first Barbeque Nation opened when?
2006 in Mumbai.
And as we speak, y'all are looking to hit that century mark anytime soon?
Well, we are looking in that direction, yes.
What's the target for the next few years in terms of expansion? 150, 200, I'm sure you have these milestones placed internally. What is the target for expansion?
We have plans for opening 25% year-on-year CAGR growth. So we are now
closer to that 100 mark, so to say.
Yes, and then 25% on that base is what we intend to continue.
So double every 3 years is what one would say.
Yes, not literally double, but yet less than double. But yes, that's the kind of number we are looking at.
Before you open an outlet of Barbeque Nations or any restaurant, what is the thought process? What are the variables that you all consider? Is it just the location? Is it the average revenue? Is it the locality, the competition? What are those variables that you consider before zeroing in on opening an outlet?
Our rent to revenue ratio has to be 10%. That's how we select the site. So for us, most important thing is the rent should be, you know, no more than 10% to the revenue. Our company level today, we are clocking a 10% rent to revenue.
That's right.
Yeah. So for us, we are not QSR where we need to be right in the ground floor, in the front of the mall or such locations. We are in Atria Mall right now, and this is on the third floor. It's a classic example where for us, location, while it's important, the rent is most important. Otherwise, the model doesn't work for us.
And what's your average payback period as far as the restaurant is concerned?
95% of our restaurants, they break even in 0 to 3 months.
Okay.
And the 5%, balance 5%, it takes about 0 to 6 months to break even. And then typically the first year of its operation, they would do store level about 10% EBITDA, and then 17, 18%, and then 25% in the third year. That's when it becomes matured. And then post that, it will grow at the rate of about 5 to 7% year on year.
So that model, you believe, is sustainable going forward as well?
Well, we have sustained it for the last 12 years.
So of the 100 restaurants that you have right now, close to 100 restaurants that you have right now, are all of them profitable?
So far, one thing I can tell you about Barbeque Nation, since the inception, we have not shut a single restaurant for lack of business. Not a single restaurant.
All your restaurants are making money, and you haven't shut any of them for the lack of business. Let's talk about where this business comes from. You guys are doing well primarily because weekdays do well for you as well. So give us the breakup of sales coming in from weekdays versus weekends, and how does that compare with your peers?
So our weekday to weekend business is almost 49%.
Okay.
And that makes our business very profitable. Also lunch versus dinner, because it's easy to fill up your restaurant in dinners and weekends. What we do good is our lunches are almost 45% in terms of cover sales than in our total business. And these weekdays are Monday to Thursday, not Friday as well. So this is Friday is part of weekend. So if I take Friday in weekday, then it will be the other way around.
All right.
So yeah, so that's that.
And what is your break-even occupancy?
On a blended basis, it could be as low as one table turn. What we do currently is almost about 1.9.
What is the average seating per restaurant that you have?
The metro and tier one would be close to about 140 average.
Mm-hmm.
And tier two and tier three cities would be about close to average of about 110.
Nearly half your revenues comes from just the three regions that you have, which is Mumbai, Bengaluru and NCR. What are you doing to decrease the concentration that these three places have?
Our 40% of our business comes from five cities,
okay,
which are metro and
tier one.
And the rest of the business, which is 60%, comes from the rest of the cities. That actually would be an opportunity, because my more business can come from newer cities. That's the plan.
Are you sure about the EBITDA that a new city will give you as against the existing older restaurant that is, you know, throwing up cash for your business? How do you ensure growth with growing profits?
So I think Barbeque Nation, if you dig deeper, have done that very well. The balance has been extremely good, because if you see the vintage chart that Barbeque Nation would have, you know, we have pre-FY13 stores, then we have FY13 stores. All these stores have, as they grow older, they are even more profitable. All the newer stores that we are opening are following the footsteps of the ones which are the older ones. I mean, pre-FY13 stores of ours, which would be about, I think, 12 to 14 stores now, are as much as 28% store level EBITDA margins stores. They are old. Typically in a restaurant business, older stores, they start losing the sheen, and then they start losing margins. But in this case, it's the other way around. And all our new stores, which are opening year by year, each year all these stores are showing the same sign as the older stores are. And every year, the margins, they increase from 10% from the first full year of its operation to 18% and then 25%. For example, all the new expansions that we take into consideration, these stores, when I mentioned to you about 10% rent to revenue, all our new stores, which are tier 2 or tier 3 cities, are 5% rent to revenue, which means there's an additional 5% margin which is created because of the rent. Just to give you another example, as we are going forward, we are opening more newer cities and tier 2, tier 3 models, which will be about 70% of our stores versus 30% of our tier 1 and metro model. Our blended rent to revenue would be as low as 8%.
Okay.
So, you know, margins are actually expanding.
As the business expands.
Yes, as the business expands. So this is what we have seen, and that's what we have seen in the last 5 years, and that's the direction we are going into.
So I'll keep it very simple, very short point. Earlier, during our chat, you said that you are looking to grow at a 25% CAGR in terms of opening your stores. That would imply doubling of the number of stores in just about 3 years. Does that mean your revenues also double? As of end FY17, you did 500 crores on the top line. Do we see 1,000 crores on the top line in FY20?
So FY18, we will be on a standalone basis, we'll be doing about 560 crores. The newer stores that we are opening will not have the same revenue per store, as these are in smaller cities and the number of covers are lesser, and the even there's a pricing is almost 15% lower than the metro and tier one. So these stores will not do the same revenue per store. So no, the restaurants may double, but the revenue may not double. It would be close to about 70% revenue.
But the EBITDA will double because you're saying
EBITDA
that as a restaurant.
Percentage-wise will be more or less the same, yes, okay. Percentage-wise. But in absolute value, it's a percentage of the top line, right?
So you're currently doing what, about 13-14% margin. Is that likely to sustain, or you have bigger triggers there?
At a store level, we are currently doing about 22.5-23%.
Okay.
And at the corporate level, we are doing about 15.5-16%. Now, the difference between 22.5 and 16% is almost 6-7% of corporate, where we have corporate and regional offices and some of the central kitchens. We have built a huge setup for future. I see that cost is now getting leveraged on larger revenue. So even that percentage improvement will happen.
So does that mean 1,000 crores of revenue in FY20 with about 18% EBITDA margins?
I feel that the business, if I take the historical data and see that the business has grown at the rate of almost 27% CAGR for last 5 years.
Right.
And frankly, the vintage play of each store can only lead to in that direction. So yes, that we are expecting that we will have a similar growth in CAGR as 27% CAGR going forward as well, yes.
So your restaurants are throwing up money, you are EBITDA positive, you're earning a lot of money. Why do you want to raise some money from the capital markets? Why the reason to go to an IPO?
Frankly, there are three reasons. One of the reasons is we have debts on the book,
which is
about 120 crores.
All right.
Part of it we want to pay off that debt.
How much is that?
We would like to pay up about 80 crores. We have some money that we want to allocate for the expansions for our international business.
International business, how much does that account for in your current revenue setup, and how much would you like to take it to?
So currently, because it's only two stores, we are closing this year at about 22 crores because we have only two stores. And we have margins are almost, like I said, for simple reason, the selling price is almost double. The margins are also much better because the entire supply chain is now connected out of India. So the food cost in India would be close to about 34%. In Middle East is almost 25%.
Okay.
So that margin is available.
So that goes to 100 crores when?
Well, it's a forward-looking statement, but
your target.
I'll give.
I'm sure you have a.
Yeah, so we do have our business plan, and we would like to open about in FY19. We would like to open about additional 8 stores to bring it to total of 17 operational in FY19, including the 6 already coming before April. So that's the plan as far as the Middle East and North Africa is concerned. We are also we have also signed up a store in Malaysia in Kuala Lumpur.
20 international stores would definitely give you in excess of 100 crore revenue.
I can tell you the model. So the model does on the first year of its operation, what it has done is 15 crores per store.
Okay.
Because that one store was operational for 1 year and it did about 15 crores of top line. Second store, which is opened in November 2017, is only 3 months old. But on a model level, like I explained, the first year The international store is done 15 crores and probably it will do about 22 crores per store.
Breaking barbecues with the MD of Barbeque Nation. Let's talk about the business of investing. Your parent company, Sayaji Hotels, that one has about 47% stake in Barbeque Nation. Are they looking to offer some stake as well?
No, Sayaji Hotel is not offering anything for sale.
Right.
It is only family which is offering about 5% for sale, and the CX Partners, which is the private equity as a part of their investment, is about 35% in the business. They would like to offer about 17% in the IPO.
So if I just take a bit of a detour and ask you about the business of Sayaji Hotels itself, what's the way ahead for the parent business itself? There were a couple of legal issues too, right?
They are expanding now. After the demise of Sayaji Dhanani, the business was consolidated. And now, after 2 years, 3 years of stabilizing and consolidating, they have clear plans and strategy to expand.
So with regards to the Indore hotel, which was asked to be vacated in 15 days and all of that, what's the status out there?
These are some of the legal matters which are being dealt with currently and under discussion with the authorities.
You spoke about the family and how the family is running that business. It took some time to consolidate after the demise of an important part in the business. So how are you trying to distance that from the business itself going forward? The mix of, say, professional family management, how are you institutionalizing the continuity of growth?
When I took over in 2012, November, all the team was sitting out of Indore, and I was based out of Bangalore, so I shifted all the entire team back in Bangalore, integrated with my existing team to start with. And then in 2 years' time, we built a team. Today, we are 470-member team of Barbeque Nation from all of 9-member team. So it has become an institution. Everything is far more structured. We have a CEO who's managing the South Asia business. We have another CEO managing the international business, based headquartered out of Dubai.
So how do you protect yourself from an important management person leaving and starting out a similar business in the competitive arena?
It's been 5 years, and I have seen a lot of that happening already.
Right.
Since 2006, there have been competitions cropping up here and there. The next best chain is 10 to 12 stores. I'm not saying competition is never going to come. I'm saying competition is healthy. Competition will always teach us newer ways and of doing things. We will jointly create larger markets, and then may best performer win.
What is that first mover advantage that you are looking at in this sector itself? Is it going to be only Barbeque Nations as a concept, or much more beyond that as well? I see you have Johnny Rockets as well. What's the opportunity there?
You know, Barbeque Nation requires a lot of focus because they have huge plans for expansions, not just in India but international as well. So we don't want to make mistakes by diluting our focus from Barbeque Nation.
But isn't that putting too many eggs in the same basket?
But I am saying that the market is different. You know, we are talking of three things here. We are talking of one, which is your tier one and tier two, tier one and metro, and then we are talking of tier two and tier three, which is absolutely a different market. We are talking of international. I don't see a reason why something like this will have any problem, as long as you keep reinventing yourself and innovating. Yes, innovation becomes important part for your day-to-day operations.
What's the money you're allocating towards Johnny Rockets, and what is the return that you expect from that?
Like I said, it is a WIP. We have not cracked the model as yet. Mm-hmm. And we would like to do any capital allocation to this project for now, until our confidence on the model is there.
Final question then. In the QSR space, a lot of investors have, really burned their fingers. it hasn't really made a lot of money for investors. So what kind of value are you leaving on the table for people who would want to subscribe to your issue?
Okay, one thing I would like to say is that our business model is such where the consumer experience is of a CDR, but entire backend is a QSR base.
So you're looking at 3x sales or 50 times price to earnings?
Doesn't really matter what I look at and what I want. It's what is reasonable and what market wants to give. So yeah, I mean, like I said, we have internal targets of growing at the rate of 25% CAGR, and we are all set to go in that direction. We have done it in the past, and I don't see any problem in future. And not to forget that we have great international growth that is coming in place, and that's going to be a great story there. So yeah, so growth is in place for us.
All right, Mr. Dhanani, it was a wonderful pleasure chatting with you. Thank you so much for joining us and giving us all those details. Wish you good luck for your IPO.
Thank you very much.